Hi, I'm Jasmine Modi. Our traditional food had scientific importance. Like during winters, we are supposed to eat lot of dried ginger, garlic, onions, spring onions, green leafy vegetables, pepper, bajri, jawar. Why all these food are winter foods? They are heat producing, so that does not allow your body temperature to go down. It maintains your body temperature. You know, I say when you have aches and pains, apply ginger juice. Does it burn?
Yeah.
But same, dried ginger has cooling properties. Basically, those herbs, what we call, they have immunity increasing properties. They have properties to fight bacteria, virals. Generally, we fall sick during winters with cold, flu, sniffles. But if we include this in our diet, we will never fall sick. That's why during winters only we are made to eat lasun ka chutney. We are not supposed to eat during summers. Chyawanprash has maximum number of herbs which increase your immunity. Vitamins, winters are the right time to take vitamins so that they are stored well and can be used throughout the year. You don't need to take it every day. Most important, ghee. We spend so much into purchasing moisturizers because our skin is getting dried. There is no internal moisture. You see our grandmothers, their skin is not as dry as ours because they've had enough ghee. Ghee does not make you fat. In fact, ghee lowers down your glycemic index. If you're having rice, have ghee with the rice. The rice glycemic index reduces, it will not make you gain weight. Ghee has anti-inflammatory properties. It has good fatty acids. It helps in transporting vital nutrients. What is root? It contains all the nutrients and water. It supplies all the nutrients to the entire tree and makes the tree supple and healthy. Root vegetables are a high source of minerals, vitamins, antioxidants. Roj suran khao, roj kand khao. It is a good source of estrogen. First 15 days of your cycle, estrogen is required to increase your follicles. Estrogen helps to control menstrual cycle. What does ambaldi do? Blood purifier. Increases blood flow. Do you know in acupuncture, what is the name of reproductive energies? Kidney energy. Color of kidney energy is black.
So we should have blood.
The shape is black. Water chestnut removes internal heat, helps in treating hypertension during pregnancy, improves fetal growth, promotes milk secretion in pregnancy, helps in muscle and neural function. Neural means nervous system. If nervous system is enhanced, blood circulation is increased. Regulates water retention, especially pregnancy water retention. It will stop excessive bleeding also. Helps prevent miscarriages. And above all, strengthens your kidney energies. It strengthens your stomach and spleen. And according to acupuncture, spleen is most important in fetal growth. First 9 weeks, which are the crucial weeks of pregnancy. Next is seeds. We take, the fruit is beneficial, the leaf is beneficial, the bark is beneficial, the branch. But from where does all this come? Who has all this information? So how important are seeds? Maximum nutritional value, seeds with. Especially for people trying to conceive, black sesame seeds. Very good. black sesame seeds help to improve blood flow to the uterus, delays aging process, prevents hair fall and premature graying of hair. Another important is that it contains zinc, which helps to repair damaged tissues in the body. Ginseng increases reproductive energies. What is ginseng? Ashwagandha. Star fruits help in getting periods. This is helpful for milk flow. Vitamin C increases your immunity, helps in weight loss. Anti-inflammatory, detoxification, iron absorption. Eating little sweet every day. Natural sweet, no white sugar. Especially people who have conceived. Little sweet is essential because we have to nourish the spleen. Spleen nourishes the fetus. It is also important to fast. But when you fast, you have to slow down. You cannot fast with your hectic schedules. Every 15 days, one fast, very good.